Hello TaleForgers, today I will discuss creating multiply ECS worlds using VContainer. A world is a collection of entities. World owns a set of systems which usually only accesses the entity within the same world. Importantly, I will create a completely new world from scratch in this tutorial. It will have default systems but without features, so no physics, Rukanka or other custom packages. I will discuss how to create a custom world with default system and features in the next video. Tutorial flow is as follows. We run scene VC05 and application will automatically create new world, default world. It is possible to disable default world auto-creation. I added link to the documentation if somebody is interested in the manual control of bootstrapping. Then we load scene VC06, which will create a game world in its scope. When we return to scene VC05, scope will call dispose on game world, and thus only default world will remain. So destroy scene means destroy scope, which dispose our custom game world, so we get beautiful encapsulation. Okay, after a brief introduction, it's time to implement the solution. Let's start with creating scene type enum with three values, none, VC05 and VC06. This will help us in the first part of the tutorial. Next, create a new script, scene loader. First of all, we want to add serialized field scene type variable. It is necessary to subscribe to the button click. So let's create button member variable. Now let's prepare awake method, where we can cache button and add listener to the onButtonClick method. Similarly, let's add onDestroy function where we remove the listener. Finally, implement onButtonClick. Inside it, we simply load scene via scene manager. As a parameter, we'll use our scene type cast to a string. Let's go to the Unity. As you can see, I have prepared new scene and directory. As always, nothing fancy. Let's create new UI button, call it scene loader button. Rename canvas to the scene loader. Reset rect transfer position and attach scene loader script to the button component. Now we can create a prefab of this object. Don't forget to choose scene type to the VC05 on our component. Next, switch to the VC05 scene and drag and drop prefab to this scene. Remember to change the scene type to the VC06. Last thing to do, let's add our newly prepared scenes to the build settings. If someone hasn't opened the Entities Hierarchy tab, go to Window, Entities, Hierarchy. It's time to test whether our scene loading is working as expected. As you can see, here is our ECS default world in the Entities Hierarchy tab. In the previous video, I have added example system in the root lifetime scope, which you can also see here, as well as scenes which are loading properly. Let's prepare example component data. It is empty struct with iComponentData interface. This structure will be the flag with which we will create entity query. Okay, it is time to prepare example offering class. It is also empty class for this particular case, so our baker will execute. Let's create example baker class inherit from baker example offering. We need to get entity with renderable flag and add example component data to it. Now in the example system struct, let's prepare new entity query called example entity query. Inside onCreate method, assign example entity query with systemapi.querybuilder dot with all example component data dot build. So we can use debug.log to find out how many elements our entity query contains, to see if our example system can see other entities in our default world, and later in our custom world. Okay, so let's go back to the Unity and wait for compilation process to finish. Switch to the VC06 scene, then create new subscene game, which will be automatically loaded in the VC06 scene. Of course, choose proper directory. Inside subscene, we need to create new object called example with example afferent script attached to it. In this way, we will have one entity with example component data on the runtime subscene thanks to the baking. It's time to test it, so return to the VC05 scene and press play. Click button to load other scene and subscene. As you can see, the example system and subscene worlds are the same, so the entity count is equal to 1. Okay, so it's time to create our custom game world. First of all, let's go to the root lightning scope and remove our ECS example system registration. We need to do it manually in the game lightning scope, so let's create a new class. This class must inherit from lightning scope. And of course, implement configure method. Now we can register our new world. That's why we need to prepare private const string game world name equals game world. Then in the construct, write builder.register new world and pass game world name as a parameter. Also pass lifetime.scope. This will ensure that our world automatically calls this pause when the VC06 scene is destroyed. Next, register system into world, example system, and pass game world name. Great! Return to the Unity, wait for the compilation process to finish, and let's open VC06 scene, where we need to create new game object, game lifetime scope and attach script. Let's go back to the VC05 and test if everything is working. As you can see, subscene is loaded in the default world, example system is created in the game world. That's why our example system is returning 0 entities. But don't worry, we have a solution. First of all, let's change private const string game world name to public. Let's add configuration method as a callback in the register new world. Inside it, we need to get all system type indices with default flag and execute in editor set to true. This method allows us to make basic system, such as scene system or ECB systems, to operate correctly. Without this, our subscene will not be able to load. Another important thing is to add the systems retrieved in this way to root level system groups. This method automatically adds all ECS systems to their appropriate system groups. Initialization, simulation and presentation groups within the specified world. Then we need to execute script behavior update order, append world to current player loop world. This way we integrate the ECS world into Unity's player's loop system, which is Unity's main execution pipeline, so on update is executed properly. To handle subscene loading, we need to have entity scene reference. So let's create scene loader component data. Inside it, we need to store entity scene reference, similar way I did it in the ECS series. Now create new class scene loader afferent. We need to add if Unity editor directive to wrap our code. This class will have one serialized field, SceneAsset, of course, AddGetter. Then let's prepare SceneLoaderBaker class. Inside it, we need to cache entity with transfer usage flag set to none. And add new component, SceneLoaderComponentData, assign SceneReference parameter to the new entity SceneReference, afferent.SceneAsset. That's it. Finally, we can create our SceneLoader system. It is system-based with one method, public entity scene reference get game scene. We don't need nothing fancy here, for example purposes. So let's write var scene loader component data equals systemapi.getSingleton scene loader component data. After that, simply return scene reference. It's right moment to implement scene loader for custom world logic. Let's change private scene type to private bool and rename variable to the isUnload. Also add a new member variable called private entity subscene entity. This will be helpful in the case of the subscene being unloaded. In the on button clicked, let's remove load scene call. We want to check our isUnload flag. If it is true, let's unload scenes and return. Otherwise, call load scenes. Let's create new method, private async void load scenes. We want to load additive our VC06 scene. This way, our game lifetime score will register new world. Then, we need to wait. To simplify this process, let's just call await unitask.waitForSeconds 1. To handle subscene loading process, it is necessary to get newly created game world. First of all, let's cache scene loader system, from which we can retrieve subscene to load via getGameScene method. Now let's go through all the worlds and see if any of them are named game world name. If so, let's write subscene entity equals to the scene system.loadSceneAsync, world.unmanage, subscene to load. Next, let's handle unloadSceneAsync function. Here, also go through all the worlds and add check condition. If game world exists, let's unload async VC06 scene, then unload our cache subscene via scene system with parameter destroy meta entities. At the end, let's assign entity.null to the subscene entity variable. Great! It's time to handle communication in the Unity editor. First, let's create new subscene, scene loader, which is a new ECS scene storing references. Inside the scene, let's create a new object with the same name and attach the scene loader afferent script. Let's remember to pass game scene reference. Now we need to open VC06 scene and select isUnload flag to true. Don't forget to remove game subscene here because we are loading it via code. Ok, go back to the VC05 scene, which is our main scene, and press play. Click the button and wait for the initialization process to execute. After that, switch to the game world. As you can see, we have a lot of scene systems here, which allow us to handle subscene loading. We can also see in the console that our entity count is equal to 1, so the subscene is in the same world as our ECS system. Fantastic! In the next video, I will show my anime wars project and discuss how to put together game world to have a default initialization. It has default world with basic systems, but also features like physics or Rook Henka, which are not available with this approach and which we would have to add manually. I would like to invite you to support us on the Patreon, where you can get the exclusive code, all models, materials or code used in this series, and access to early available content. Link in the description. Thank you for your time, I'm glad you are with us and our community is growing. See you soon in the next video.